In this video, we're solving a dynamics problem where two blocks are tied together with a string and then they're accelerated upward. And what we're given this time is a little bit unusual. We were told the breaking strength for these strings is 75 newtons, and we want to find the maximum acceleration for the two blocks, and then we want to find the tension for the string in between the blocks. So the key starting point here is to realize that T1, that's the tension in the upper string, that's responsible for accelerating all 5 kilograms of mass here. So that one's always going to have a bigger tension. And that means we'll get our maximum acceleration when we push T1 right up to the breaking strength of 75 newtons. And then we should find that T2 is less than 75 newtons at this acceleration. So probably the easiest way to get a handle on this problem of finding the maximum acceleration is to just draw a circle around all 5 kilograms and say, well, T1 is responsible for accelerating all 5 kilograms. All right, so now we're just treating the whole collection as a single 5 kilogram mass being acted on from the outside by T1 pulling up, but also gravity acting down. And notice in that picture, I showed the force of gravity as a shorter vector because I know T1 has to be bigger than the force of gravity to cause an upward acceleration. So we'll go ahead and write in the magnitude of our force of gravity here. That's mg, and we're using a total mass of 5 kilograms, and then g is 9.8 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers here, we end up with 49 newtons for the force of gravity pulling down. We also recall that T1 is right at its limit of how big it can be before the string breaks. That's 75 newtons. And then the unknown here is the acceleration. So we apply Newton's second law to this thing. That's F net equals ma. And the net force is 75 newtons pointing up from that tension minus this 49 newtons pointing down. That's the force of gravity pulling down on this thing. That's all equal to the mass, which is 5 kilograms, times our unknown acceleration, little a. Doing the subtraction over there on the left-hand side and then dividing by 5, we find an acceleration of 5.2 meters per second squared. Okay, now we're ready to look at part B, where we're asked to find the tension in the string between the two blocks. And the simplest way to do this is to just focus our analysis on the 3 kilogram block itself. So we focused our attention on the 3 kilogram block, and we see two forces acting on that guy. We have T2 pulling up, and that's actually what we're trying to find here. And then we have the force of gravity pulling down. That's given again by mg, but this time we're just talking about 3 kilograms. And when we run the numbers on this, 3 times 9.8 gives us 29.4 newtons for the force of gravity. So this time when we apply Newton's second law, again, F net equals ma, we plug in our net force, and our upward force, T2, is unknown. Our downward force of gravity on this block, that's 29.4 newtons. The mass of the block is 3 kilograms. And our acceleration is known because we found it in the first part of the problem. So that's 5.2 meters per second squared. So now we just have to smash the numbers into a calculator and solve for T2. And this comes out to 45.0 newtons. Now I don't want to quit without showing you how you can check your work in a problem like this. What we're going to do is a complete force analysis on the 2 kilogram block. And then if we find the same acceleration that was observed in part A, we know everything is fitting together here. So we just found that T2 is 45.0 newtons. That's pulling down on the 2 kilogram block because strings always pull at both ends. In addition to that, we have gravity pulling down on the 2 kilogram block. And so plugging in a mass of 2 kilograms, we have to calculate 2 times 9.8, which is 19.6 newtons. Now we apply Newton's second law to this guy. And I have 75 newtons pointing upward. I've got 45 newtons pointing downward. That's the string pulling down on this block. And an additional 19.6 newtons pulling down on this block. That's going to be equal to the size of the mass, which was 2, multiplied by A. So when we smash all the numbers on the left side of that equation, and divide by 2, we end up with the exact same answer for A. That's 5.2 meters per second squared. And we have a high level of confidence that we've done everything right in this problem. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.